Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. So who's ready to eat?
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I'm ready to eat. We're going to have our introduction of speaker, our very own Evander Shelley. Good word of praise, Lord, as she comes.
Okay, and now we can't we give a praise for Jesus, amen? That was cool to me, but let's just give it up for Jesus, amen? If I can have you stand up on your feet all over the building. See, when we go to eat, we come in expectation of a meal, amen? We come in expectation of some good food, right?
I will not break down. I
have caught me about 30 years ago when I didn't know who I was. You should have caught me about 20 years ago when I was a little timid and shy.
Rather have
it go back 10 steps. Then the prophet Isaiah called to the Lord, and the Lord made the shadow go back 10 steps. It had gone down to the stairway of Azaz. Philippians, the 4th chapter, the 12th verse. I'm not going to read it all, but it says, I know what it is meant, what it is to be in need. I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation. Whether well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in lack. Turn to your neighbor real quick and just ask them, are you a victim of circumstance or a warrior of change? Or ask somebody else, are you a victim of circumstance or are you a warrior of change? Or I need you to turn around and ask somebody else, are you a victim of your circumstance or will you be a warrior for change? Hallelujah. You may take your seats. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Listen here, I need to catch everybody up and make sure we're all on the same page. Hezekiah was a good king. He walked faithfully before the Lord. He rebuilt and restored some of the temples that his father had brought in idolatry and other gods into. But Hezekiah, he got in there and he did his thing.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
Hallelujah. He brought things back in order. Hallelujah. So when he got this news that he was going to die, it wasn't because of any type of sin. It was just what it was. It just is what it is sometimes.
Come on now.
But I love his response to the circumstance. God wants to know today, when we're faced with circumstance, will we become victims of that circumstance? Let's talk about being a victim for a minute, if that's all right. Hallelujah. What is a victim mentality? A victim mentality is one where you blame everyone else for what happens in your world. A victim mentality is when you don't have hope for your future. Oh, it's going to turn out negative because that's how it always turns out. Hallelujah. If you don't get the promotion, it's because Mr. Johnson was out to get you. Forget about the fact that he saw you playing on the internet all day. Throw that out the window. Couldn't have been that. Hallelujah. Your best friend called and she couldn't have dinner with you. She's always doing that to me. Never mind the fact that you called her at the last minute, wanting her to rearrange her schedule, and because she could not accommodate you, you fell into a pity party and became a victim. Listen, saints of God, we got to learn how to accept no. Y'all don't want to get with me? Y'all don't want to get with me? Just because you hear the word no, don't mean that the devil is attacking you. Sometimes God will tell you no. You may not see it in the midst of it. It said Hezekiah, he wept bitterly. But I love his response. It says that he turned his face toward the wall and began to pray. Check this out, y'all. Why would he turn his face toward the wall? Let me paint the picture. He laying in his sick bed, Brother John, and all the people was gathered around him. So Hezekiah said, let me turn my back on my distractions. I don't need no help right up through here. This is about me and my Savior. Too many times we look for folks to pull us out of situations and circumstances when God is saying, all you got to do is come to me.
Come on now.
But we like quick fixes. We like real quick fixes. Well, God, I would rather go to Minister Marie because you know I would rather go to Brother John, because you know, when God is saying, if you will only come to me. Oh, we going somewhere, y'all. Jesus. Listen. It said that Hezekiah turned his face towards the wall and began to remind God about some things. Remind God of how he served him. Remind God of his faithfulness. Remind God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Listen, Apostle, I'm trying not to get ahead of myself. I'm trying to walk through this real gingerly right through here, because we all got to get this. But let me tell you something. Hezekiah asked. He said, will you heal me, God? And God's response, before he even finished praying real good, the prophet even didn't make it from amongst him. Then he went back and told him, God heard you.
Hey.
He heard you. He gonna turn it around. He gonna fix it. Get the stuff. Get the figs. It was some type of ointment or something they put together. And just put it on the boil.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on.
There was miraculous healing.
Yes. Thank you.
Apostle, it was after 3 days.
Come on now. Hallelujah.
Doug, I'm trying to take y'all with me. Listen. You went in on a Friday night. You came out on a Sunday. In my book, that's 3 days. Don't be surprised, man of God, if you go back and they tell you that it's gone. We can't find it. We can't see it. Don't be surprised. God is that kind of God. That's the kind of God we serve. Listen, when Hezekiah got the news, he didn't fall into a pity party. The Bible did say that he wept bitterly. Nobody is asking you to be a superhuman. Sometimes things are going to hurt, Brother John. Sometimes you're going to get a little discouraged. You're going to get a little disappointed. But that's the time that you get in the face of God. And you get real honest with him. And you tell him, Father, I'm hurting. I need you to touch me, God. Father, my heart is broken. Y'all playing. Maybe you ain't ever been through nothing. And maybe your friend, your cousin, you know, that one you took to the fight with you. Maybe they ain't never hurt your feelings. Maybe they ain't never didn't show up for you. But sometimes we will find ourselves in situations where we get disappointed. That is not the time to hook up with Susie, because Susie got issues. Because Susie got issues, she don't want you to get over your issues. So here you come with your pity party.
I'm sure. They hurt me. Well, girl, I told you they was going to hurt you. You didn't know. Susie, ain't no prayer in Susie. Ain't no word in Susie. By the time you leave Susie, you feel worse than you felt when you got there. Stop allowing people to speak victimization into your life. What are you saying, prophetess? What are you saying, prophetess? Yeah.